Hey, how's it going? Dave2D here. So this is a video that's not one of my regular hardware videos. It's about something that has plagued Windows laptops for a really long time. It's this issue that just keeps popping up here and there, and it doesn't matter if your laptop is new or old or expensive or cheap. It doesn't matter because you can still have this issue. It's the trackpads. There are Windows laptops out there, lots of them, that have really crappy trackpads. And it boils down to one thing, software. If you have great hardware, like this one, glass surface, great button mechanics, but it's got crappy software. It's running Elan drivers. And if you're one of those laptop owners that's running something with an Elan driver or a Synaptics driver, you're not having a good time with your trackpad. At least you can have a better time with your trackpad using Windows Precision drivers. And this video explains how to put those drivers onto your existing laptops. So first you have to figure out whether your laptop is running Elan drivers or Synaptics drivers. And to do that, you just go into Control Panel, check out the Device Manager, and you'll be able to see what you're running. And if you're not running either one of those two, you're either running Windows Precision drivers already, or you're running something weird that this video can't help you with. Okay, once you figure out which one you have, either Elan or Synaptics, you download one of the two files that are linked in the video description. One is for people with Synaptic trackpads, and the other is for people with Elan trackpads. And depending on which one you have, you just download the appropriate one. But in case you're wondering, both of these files are actually from Lenovo. They weren't meant for this kind of hack that we're doing. They were meant for something else, obviously, but they work perfectly for this kind of replacement of the Synaptic or Elan trackpad drivers. So once you have the file, you extract it either by running the exe or unzipping it, and it'll place all the files into a folder called drivers in your root. And then you go into your device manager again, right click your trackpad, whether it's the Elan one or Synaptic one, and then you go update driver, browse my computer, choose let me pick, and then click on have disk. Now if you have a laptop with an Elan driver, you go for the ETD.inf file, and for laptops with a Synaptic trackpad, choose the Synaptic driver. So basically you're replacing the existing drivers on your laptop, whether they be Elan or Synaptics, and you're replacing them with Windows 10, like the Windows Precision touchpad drivers, which are so much better. And the biggest difference you'll notice is, I mean, tracking is smooth and everything. Tracking is just much more accurate with the Windows Precision drivers. But the big one is gestures. Being able to use the Windows 10 gestures both accurately and reliably makes the trackpad so much better. Okay, before you run off to do this, I need to leave a couple kind of disclaimers with you. First, you do this at your own risk. I've obviously tested this on many computers, probably 40, maybe 50 laptops. And for the laptops that this worked on, they've been great. But for the ones that it didn't work on, they exploded. No, for the ones that it didn't work on, the drivers just won't update. Windows will be like, sorry, bud, you can't take these drivers. And that's the end of that. But the other thing you have to keep in mind is that you can't let Windows overwrite your new drivers with like an automatic Windows update. That's very, very annoying because sometimes you won't even know that it's updated and all of a sudden the trackpad's gone back to its old disgusting self, and you'll have to figure out that, hey, it's because Windows overwrote it, and you'll have to redo the process. So you just need to make sure that you're kind of downloading the appropriate update. You don't want to download something that's like the new Elan or the new Synaptics driver. You want to avoid those. And the other thing to keep in mind is that if you want to, you should probably back up or find a backup of your old existing drivers in case you want to revert back to them. So go to your manufacturer, download that driver in advance before you do any of this stuff, before you try it. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed this video. I really hope this was helpful because this has existed for probably over a year. Kind of, it's gone better over time, especially with the new Lenovo driver that just recently came out, like maybe 2-3 weeks ago. It's way better now. This works on a lot of laptops. Enjoy. Okay, thumbs if you like this video, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time.